Hi all, Mike from Wunderschikan TV here. We're ready to optimize the VR settings for another racing simulator today. It's iRacing and we will be using OpenXR Toolkit to get high clarity settings on a HP Reverb G2 headset together with a Nvidia RTX 3080 graphics card. As usual, if you enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And now let's have a look at the settings. The first settings that we're taking are within the iRacing user interface. So start it. And it will connect to iRacing. And once you're there, click here on the right hand side on this item to open your profile, select settings, go to interface, and here in the default display mode, make sure that OpenXR is selected here as the option. Close the window. Download OpenXR Toolkit from the link provided in the video description and install it. Afterwards, start a test drive in iRacing. The game will go into the VR mode, and when you are in the cockpit, you can use Control plus F2 to access the configuration menu of OpenXR Toolkit. Use Control F3. Control F2 and Control F1 to navigate and go to the menu folder first. There, activate the option Show Expert Settings by setting it to Yes. Next, we move to the performance section. We don't need to turn on a frames per second counter in the overlay, because iRacing has its own counter. We use the upscaling CIS at a sharpness of 70%. Fixed foveated rendering is set to custom. You can use the cull outer mask option and set it to yes if you experience low FPS. I left it here off for the sake of nicer screenshots. The inner ring size is 55% at a resolution of 1/4. The outer ring size 80% with a resolution of 1/16. We prefer the horizontal resolution. We set the horizontal scale to 150%. And we add a vertical offset of +15% to move the center of sharpness to the windscreen of the car in the cockpit. We use the turbo mode on. Everything else stays on default here. The Appearance tab and the Inputs tab stay on default, so there is nothing really to explain about these two. And we can now directly move towards the System tab. Main thing about the System tab is to use the Override Resolution item. We set it to Yes and we select a display resolution, in my case of 3000x2923 pixels. If you are on a stronger graphics card than I'm on RTX 3080, you can try to push these values even higher for better sharpness. The motion reprojection stays on default, all other items remain unchanged. So you see we're using here a field of view of 100% of all dimensions. This is already it for the OpenXR Toolkit settings. We will give our final polish to our settings in the in-game settings of iRacing, which are also accessible when you are looking through the VR headset. Here are my in-game settings. iRacing itself is a very VR-friendly game. Let's briefly walk through the main items of them with some explanation. Otherwise, just follow the content of the screen here and set your settings appropriately. The first section on top under display relates to the VR mirror on the flat screen in most options. However, this VR mirror is quite buggy. I've never been able to get it to real full screen, and it looks horrible compared to what you see inside the VR headset. I select here the option Enable SPS VR. In terms of performance, you see that most items are maxed out. Really important for the good VR settings is that you set the frames per second limiters to 91 so that the maximum frame rate of the HP Reverb G2 is used. Anisotropic filtering and AA samples mode is important for the performance. You can set them to 16 times and 8 times. They will give the nice image quality. Shadow maps and cloud shadows are turned off. They are big frame eaters. Also, night shadow maps and the wall numbers are big frame raters. Under the option number of lights, there's a filter option, which is set in my settings to no filter. This option, if you select any of the filters that are proposed, you will also get a lot of FPS losses. So just stay with no filters. On the right hand side, under customs, I'm using the real mirrors in the car and I set them to the maximum number of 4. This is really important for immersion. I skip the option of higher detail in the mirrors. The headlights are set to low detail and I deactivate the options of headlights on track in mirrors. This is all for performance. Further down low, you see anti-aliasing is turned off. It's not necessary and it's also big frame per second eater. On the RTX 3080, you experience a loss of frames per second when you set it, for example, to SMAA, but you can give it a try on stronger graphic cards like the 3090 or 4080 or 4090. Sharpening is important for image quality and HDR will give you nice sun glare effects. The video mem swap high res cars option can be used, and you can even use the high resolution 2048x2048 car textures. Last but not least, there are two sliders in the bottom of this option screen. Just put both towards the maximum, especially the one of the GPU video memory is important to set up to maximum value. Otherwise, you may experience blurry textures, for example, on billboards. Compared to other titles, iRacing is very easy to set up. No need to go, for example, for Open Composite. OpenXR is supported out of the box. Together with OpenXR Toolkit and the in-game settings, it's very easy to achieve nice looking settings at high frames per second. I hope you enjoyed my video and you get along really well with my settings. I appreciate your feedback in the comments and I will see you on track.